الرحمن الرحيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، وبعد. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. This is سورة الإخلاص. But also it has another name. What's the other name? سورة التوحيد. The surah of Tawheed, the oneness of Allah. There is no one that is deserving to be known as one but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why we will take only the last two bits of the surah where Allah gives himself the sifah, the attribute, and the names that he did not beget, nor was he begotten, and there is no one like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in resemblance. Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even bother to bring this down while people were still believing in him? In the Quran itself, you find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says also in Surah Az-Zumar, just at the beginning of Surah Az-Zumar, perhaps the second or third verse, مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى. We do not worship these idols except that we want them to help us to be close to Allah so that they can draw us close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think about it. In another verses, some religions or some people whom they claim to be the followers of Moses, they might have said that we are the children of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we are his beloved ones. Think about it. In other verses, they would even say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has begotten female children for himself. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Why would these people say this? It's because they believed, because they have idols they are worshipping, they can be a medium between them to intercede for them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Does it even make sense? If we want to know how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, and why do we regard him as the majestic, the one who deserves glory, and the one whom we exalt, why should he have partners? Allah says, لَوْ كَانَ فِيهِمَا آلِهَةٌ. If there were to be a number of lords, إِلَّا اللَّهِ, except for Allah, لَفَسَدَتَا, the earth and the heavens would have corrupted. In another verse in Surah Al-Mu'minun, he says, مَتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ مِنْ وَلَدٍ. Allah did not beget a child. وَمَا كَانَ مَعَهُ مِنْ, and never was there another god with him, another deity with him. Then if that was the case, definitely the lam that is used over here for لَذَهَبَ لِلتَّوْكِيد, for affirmation that every god, every deity would have gone with what they've created themselves. Subhanallah wa ta'ala amma yasifun. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be the one who is exalted from what they have attributed him with. What do we learn for me and you? When we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even our desires should not be connected with Allah's worship. Because Allah says, أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهَهُ هَوَاهُ. O Muhammad, have you considered the case of the one who takes his Lord to be his desires? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes him go astray out of his knowledge, and makes his ears, his heart, his eyes, he puts a seal on all of them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make this happen to us. But have you looked into that, me and you also? Which means that what we desire, as long as it's against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we do not have and we should not act upon it. But bear in mind, every shirk is shirk, whether minor or major. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not beget, nor was he begotten, and nor should he have any association with any other partners. We have to worship Allah as how he is, and unify him as a Lord, and not bring him with any other thing to associate him with something that does not belong to him.